नई दिल्ली में आयोजित एक कार्यक्रम के दौरान विदेश मंत्री एस जयशंकर ने भारत और अमेरिका के संबंधों को लेकर अपने विचार साझा किए। उन्होंने कहा कि शीत युद्ध की समाप्ति के साथ ही H-1B वीजा ने भारत अमेरिका के संबंधों को मजबूत करने में अहम भूमिका निभाई है। जयशंकर ने अपनी बात को समझाते हुए कहा कि जब पंडित नेहरू पहली बार अमेरिका दौरे पर गए थे तो उस वक्त अमेरिका में 3,000 भारतीय मूल के लोग थे। जब इंदिरा गांधी पहली बार अमेरिका गईं तो वहां 30,000 भारतीय मूल के लोग थे। जब राजीव गांधी अमेरिका गए तो 3 लाख भारतीय मूल के लोग थे और जब नरेंद्र मोदी गए तो यह संख्या बढ़कर 33 लाख से ज्यादा हो चुकी है। विदेश मंत्री ने कहा कि अमेरिका ने भारतीय मूल के लोगों ने अपनी मेहनत, स्किल और प्रतिभा के दम पर अमेरिकी समाज में अपनी जगह बनाई है। लोग किसी भी देश के प्रतिनिधि होते हैं, साथ ही क्या कुछ कहा आइए सुनवाते हैं।
You know, I often said, some of you would have heard me say this before, it's something I read in a very useful book on the India-US relations, that when Nehru first went to America, there were 3,000 Indian Americans. When Indira Gandhi went it first time as PM, it was 30,000. When Rajiv Gandhi went, it was 300,000. When Narendra Modi went, it was 3.3 million. So I mentioned that because I think, one, there is a quantitative side of it. But I think there's also, as I said, it's the skills, the talent, the contribution which the diaspora has made there, you know. I still remember, this is when I was ambassador, I was meeting a very well-known politician. I will tell Eric the name privately later on. From the deep south, and you know, he actually told me, saying that, look, you know, I had this view of Indians, and then my wife had some issue, and she went to this doctor who was an Indian, and he was so good. And so why I say this is, people eventually put a face to a country. When we speak about members of the diaspora, now sometimes people are not conscious of it, okay? I mean, I'm not saying everybody, when particularly in America, ask people, okay, what's the country of your origin? I mean, otherwise your conversation would not go beyond that. But by and large, when in America people see the diaspora, members of the diaspora do well, they associate it with their image of India. And that then shapes their views about India. I mean, it is true all over the world, but I would say it is particularly true of the United States, because the United States in many ways is a very unique society, and because it has immigration from so many different sources, it has a way of using its immigration flows to also create a kind of a foreign policy metrics.